Today, we are at one of the most rare and unique spots I've ever showcased here on the channel. We are in Galesburg, Michigan at the Eppstein House, which was designed by the very famous architect Frank Lloyd Wright. I actually grew up in high school learning all about this guy, so it feels pretty surreal to actually be staying overnight in one of his homes. If you have an appreciation for architecture, interior design, and history, you are really going to enjoy this tour. So without further ado, let's go and check out the Eppstein House. Welcome to the Eppstein House. This is what I would call the entry or the side exterior. From these angles, you can see just how long this house is. It's pretty massive and has an incredibly unique layout. Let's begin to head inside. You'll come to this outdoor seating area with a bench and picnic table. The front door is actually behind that wall or barrier on the left. So we'll round the corner, open up this door, and let's come inside to the interior because we have a lot to cover on this tour. When you first enter, you'll see this long hallway. At the end is the living room. We're gonna turn to the left though and enter into the nearest room, which is the kitchen. Upon first glance, you still have that lovely old school mid-century modern charm. And I read online that the owners did a full restoration project back in 2017. You'll notice a lot of your bowls and plates on those shelves and then a huge opening up in the ceiling to let all of the natural light in into the kitchen. There's also your coffee and tea maker, your sink, and lots of countertop space on this end. Now in this opposite corner, there are a bunch of condiments for all of your cooking needs. But my main reason for pointing out this area is you have an original Kellogg's cornflakes box. I mean, how cool is that? There's also this huge old fashioned stovetop and oven setup. Finally, on this other side, you have a wrap around counter and some other appliances like your microwave and two refrigerator units on the bottom. Let's now exit the kitchen and walk down that same hallway to come into the living room. You first see this beautiful and large seating area, which I'll get to shortly, but I want to point out this spot on the right. This is the Frank Lloyd Wright wall. You have this large painting with the man himself, then a bunch of books and drawings on that little shelf, which I strongly encourage you to flip through. He had a very storied career, designing over 1,000 structures over the course of 70 years. Right next to the Frank Lloyd Wright wall is this simple and modern fireplace. This is actually one of two indoor fireplaces in the home. This is now the main hangout area in the living room. There are a lot of different seating options. This is a great Airbnb, I think, to book for a large family gathering. You could fit everybody in this one area. This is the main couch. There's also a bunch of other chairs and two main coffee tables right here in the middle. Let's now pan a little more to the right to explore the other half of this main room. I'll start first in this corner. You have this large desk, which has some more drawings and information specific to this home on top of it. They include some building plans, I believe, some newspaper clippings, and even some transcripts from the original owner. Overall, this is some pretty in-depth and very neat historical info I enjoyed reading through. Finally, for this main area, let's venture to this side to the dining room. You have a dining table here with enough seating for 5 people. I also got a lot of my work done at this very chair, and I love that backdrop with the shelf and all the decorations. There's also an additional hallway behind the table, which leads back to the kitchen. The shelf is lined head to toe with books. There's also some classic decorations like you see here. And on the far left, you have some more bowls and additional cooking supplies near the kitchen. To round out this main room, I'll quickly point out that this entire wall is made up of windows, so light is streaming in at all times of the day, and you're looking out into your courtyard, which we'll go to now. To get to the courtyard and the main exterior, I'll open up these huge floor-to-ceiling doors, which takes us here. This is a zoomed-out version with the drone. It's my favorite angle of the exterior. You can see into the large courtyard area here and further into the forest and beyond. You'll notice if we pan out with the drone just how tall that stone wall is and the size of the courtyard area. This entire section of the home is quite elevated above the ground. If you look to the left now, you can see a little sneak peek again of just how long this home is, but I'll save that more for later because we're now gonna go back inside to see more of the interior. This leads to the longest hallway I have ever seen before in an Airbnb. Yes, I'm literally running up and down it to demonstrate the length. We'll go into bedroom number 1 of 3 now. On the left-hand side, you have a chair and a lot of storage space. On the opposite wall, you have a desk that you can work out of, and there's a door, which we'll walk through now, which leads to a laundry room, which is directly connected to the bedroom. You have your washer and dryer and a sink. We'll actually go through that door on the left now because I want to quickly point out some stuff on the side exterior of the home. I love this part of the Airbnb. There are just so many different slants, angles, windows, doors, different parts of the roof, everywhere that you look. For the first time as well, I'm now gonna take the drone and go from right to left to show the entire length of this home. It just keeps going on and on and on. This place is pretty gigantic. If we get closer, you do have a picnic table so you can dine outside if you would like, and there's a large fire pit next to that, which I unfortunately didn't have time to use. But here is a quick bird's eye view of the home zoomed out with the drone. Just the pure geometry of this home is pretty amazing. Finally, this is the last angle of the home that I'll show. Let's now go and finish up the interior. This home is a piece of art as a whole, in my opinion. And while I'm not quite ready to invest in my own home or Airbnb property quite yet, I am ready to invest into something else very unique, and that is done through a company called Masterworks. I was always taught early on to have multiple income streams and to diversify my investment portfolio. I currently have investments in stocks, mutual funds, and even crypto. I'll now be adding in another investment channel by investing in art through Masterworks. This is very attractive to me because art is one of the most stable forms of investments out there. It'll help balance my other allocations in crypto and stocks, which are definitely a lot riskier. Even if you don't want to wait until Masterworks finds a buyer, you can actually sell your shares in the art to another user on their secondary market. It's just like buying and selling stocks on an app like Robinhood. It's worth noting that contemporary art prices actually outpace the S&P 500's total return by 164% from 1995 to 2021. Plus, I mean, come on, it's just really cool. Like, I can own a piece of this work of art from Banksy, one of my favorite artists that I studied a lot in college. Contemporary art collection also used to be limited just to art collectors and even billionaires. But now me, your friendly neighborhood YouTuber, can also have a part in all of this. It's super easy to get started. You just visit their website, create an account, and you can then start to browse all of the art. So if you're ready to get started, check out the link down in my video description. Let's now get back to the tour so I can show off this gorgeous room that I'm in right now in the Eppstein house. Back inside, there is a bathroom directly connected to the laundry room and right around the corner from that first bedroom that we saw. In particular, I thought the shower curtain design was on point and felt very Frank Lloyd Wright to me for some reason. We'll now go next door further down the hall into what I would probably consider to be the master bedroom. You can see the network of doors and halls from this angle, which I'll get to next. And if we now look above the bed, this entire wall is covered with windows to let in as much light as possible. To the right of the bed, you have an extra blanket, chair, and some essentials. There's also a mirror and a dresser for some extra storage in this other corner. But let's now take the camera and pan more to the left. We're gonna go through that other door to continue the tour. This door on the left leads to your ensuite bathroom. There are 2 bathrooms total here in the Eppstein house. This bathroom could be accessed either from directly within the bedroom or from the hallway. This side of the bathroom has your sink and toilet though, and then further back you have your large shower with some bluish green tile. But I'm now gonna exit and run further down the hallway to keep going. Almost at the end of the hallway now, we'll come into the third and final bedroom. You actually have two desks in this room, so I envision maybe the kids might pick this room. Along this wall, you have this large kind of retro looking day bed with some more cool decorations and paintings up on that shelf and along the wall. I also noticed a lot of this room was a little car themed with some of the books you see right here, so you can cozy up with a book on the day bed. To get to the final room, we're gonna walk up this red staircase. I'll quickly point out this huge shelf, which takes up basically this entire wall. There are a lot more books and decorations for you to check out during your stay, but this leads to basically the second living room or the family room. This black lounge chair in the far corner was my hangout spot of choice. We'll now come into the main area. I thought everything from the color scheme to the rug to the pillows really matched the mid-century modern aesthetic that the home goes for. Over here, you have a large DVD collection and a small TV. Personally, I was fine with the size of the TV because I think you come here more to read books and enjoy the home, not to watch television. Lastly, in this corner, you have a wood-burning stove and plenty of fire-starting supplies that is left for you, so I'm gonna get this thing up and running. And here we are, all good to go. Despite this being more of an architectural gem, or maybe more for design lovers, you still get that cozy cabin feeling here at the Eppstein House. This is definitely a great spot to rent for a group or a family. Last but certainly not least, in this far corner, you have one of the most extensive collection of records I've ever seen before at an Airbnb. So you can play some of your favorite songs while enjoying this incredible space with your loved ones. Thanks for watching, guys. All booking links and information is down in the video description, and I'll see you all very soon for another Airbnb tour.